said, my God, here is Paul, who has the gift of healing. And God said to him, no, my grace is sufficient. In other words, Paul, I'm not going to change your circumstance, but I am going to give you the grace that you need to deal with it. Tell somebody, deal with it. Sometimes you just got to deal with it. But how can something as beautiful as the grace of God be so painful? How can something so wonderful, so effervescent, cause me to hurt so much? Can I illustrate it? Do it. It is like a husband who wants to show his wife how much he loves her. And so he buys for his wife a box of freshly cut roses wrapped in a bow. He gives her the box. Her eyes are beaming. Her heart is palpitating. She's excited to get the box. She can hardly untie the bow fast enough. She opens the box, and immediately she sees the beautiful roses, and she could smell the wonderful fragrance. She reaches inside in excitement and grabs the roses, but she grabbed them by the stem. Immediately, pain shoots up her arm. Blood begins to gush out of her hand. Something so beautiful, and yet something so painful. Now she has a choice. She can say to the rose, Rose, I reject you because you hurt me. You caused me pain. Or she could become angry with her husband and say, Joker, if you really loved me, you would have taken the time to shave these thorns off the stem. But did you know what she does? Surprisingly, she doesn't throw the rose down, nor does she become angry with her husband. She continues to hold the rose by the stem in spite of the pain, because she knows that the intent of the giver was not to hurt her, but to show her how much he loved her. Come here, let me ask you a question. Can you hold God by the stem? By the stem when a loved one dies. By the stem when the doctor says it's cancer. By the stem when you're laid off from your job, because you know God's intent was never to hurt you, but to show you how much he loved you. I'm under no illusions. With this many people here tonight, somebody do it came to church. You didn't even want to go to church tonight. Somehow you drug your way out of your house, made your way to the house of God, hurting and bleeding, holding God by the stem. Somehow you know you're hurting, and yet you say, God, I still have made up my mind. I'm going to love you. I'm still going to praise you. I'm still going to worship you. That's when you mature in your faith. And I've come to say to the church, it's time to grow up. Is there somebody that can worship God if you don't get the house, if you don't get the car, if you don't get your healing, if you don't get your breakthrough, if God doesn't give you your job back, can you still say, my faith looks up to thee? That's grace for grown-ups, not for little boys, not for little girls. When you can love God when God is allowing you to bleed, when you can love God when God is allowing you to hurt, that God may not heal your mama, God may not deliver your child. Don't get me wrong, I believe he's Jehovah Jireh, he's Jehovah Rapha, he is a God of healing. I believe it. But child of God, sometimes God says, no.